So today let's take a look at something called mouse keys. You'll find it in System Preferences, in Accessibility, under Mouse and Trackpad. You'll see Enable Mouse Keys and then Options. Let's take a look at the options. Options here are whether to press the Option key, also known as the Alt key on your keyboard, 5 times. That toggles it on or off. This is going to be important because you don't always want it on. You can also set it to ignore the trackpad when mouse keys is turned on. And there's initial delay and maximum speed for it. But let's take a look at what mouse keys does. So if I enable it, let's go and turn on the Option key option there. So I'll press the Option key 5 times. And actually, you see I get an indicator on my screen there that says it's on. The checkbox here in System Preferences, if I happen to have that visible, shows that it's turned on. Now I can use mouse keys. So if you have a numeric keypad, now those numbers act kind of as a joystick for controlling the mouse. For instance, you can use the 1 to move the cursor to the lower left. You can use a 3 to move to the lower right. You know, all that. I don't have a numeric keypad on my keyboard, but that's okay. But I could still use keys. The 789 UIOJKL keys will work in that way. So the U key moves the cursor to the left, the O to the right, 8 up, and K down. And the keys next to that will move it diagonally, like here is the 7 key. So I can move the key, the cursor around. If I click and hold, it will move it continuously. And that's where the delay comes in. Now what does the I key do in the middle, or the 5 key on the numeric keypad? That actually will click. So for instance, I can move over to this Options button here and I can hit the I key to click. And I can still use my trackpad here. That's what I'm doing here. So I have the best of both worlds. Now I just hit I there to actually click and get rid of it. So what happens if I want to type? Well, that's why you want to toggle it on or off. This is for controlling the cursor. Now I use the Option key 5 times and now I switch it off and now I can type. And when I want to use the cursor again, I press the Option key 5 times and now I can use those keys on my keyboard or numeric keypad to move around. Now it turns out this is not a unique Mac feature. As a matter of fact, mouse keys, you can look it up in Wikipedia, it's been around since 1984 and was originally part of X Windows, which was a kind of a windowing system for Unix. And it's available in Microsoft Windows and other systems as well. So Apple did invent this, they're just enabling this as a standard. And you can see here that there are more than just those 8 keys for directions and the click key. You also have the 0 in period for kind of click down and click up. That's useful because you can actually grab and drag things. So you can hit the 0 to grab something and then continue to move the cursor to move that thing around, and then the period key on the numeric keypad to lift up the mouse. Now, if you don't have a numeric keypad, I find that the M, comma, and period keys work as well. And you can kind of get some of these other ones working with the keys around there. You kind of have to figure it out and play with it. But it does indeed work with the standard keyboard, not just the ones with the numeric keyboard. So you can read here a little bit about the history of it and see that it is kind of an interesting standard. What's it good for? Well, obviously if you're having trouble with the mouse or trackpad and you need to be able to just navigate with the cursor using the keyboard, it's useful. That's why it's in accessibility functions. But also it can be useful in situations, for instance, when your mouse or keyboard isn't working and you need to go to some functions or do something in order to get it to work again, or to do so temporarily until you get a replacement mouse or trackpad. So it's very handy to know that it's there. So you might ask, well, if my mouse or trackpad isn't working, how do I even get to enable mouse keys? Well, there are a lot of different ways to do it. Here's one. I'm going to use FN Control F2 to bring the focus to the menu up there, and I can use the arrow keys to go back and forth. I'm going to go down here on the Apple key, go to System Preferences, hit Return. Then I'm going to search for mouse keys, and I'm going to go to it, which is called Make Mouse and Trackpad Easier to Use. I'll go into that. There it is there. Now how do I get to the checkbox? If I tab, it's going to tab between those two things there. So I don't want it to do that. I can do FN Control, and you may not need the FN key depending upon how you have your settings. So it could just be Control F7 or Control FN F7. I toggle that, and now notice it goes between all items including these checkboxes here. So I can go back and forth, and when the Enable Mouse Keys checkbox is there, I press the space bar to enable it, and now I can actually move the cursor around the screen using the keys there. So there are ways to do this.